गुड डे एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ तृप्ति मिश्रा, आई वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल NCERT साइंस। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास 10th चैप्टर 1 केमिकल रिएक्शन एंड इक्वेशन पार्ट 4। इन टुडेज टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस डिस्प्लेसमेंट रिएक्शंस एंड डबल डिस्प्लेसमेंट रिएक्शंस। So first we will discuss displacement reaction. As the name indicate, displacement means to displace. In this type of reaction, one of the more reactive element displaces the less reactive element from its compound. That's why the reaction is called displacement reaction. To understand this reaction, we will do an activity. In this activity, we will take 3 iron nails and clean them by the rubbing with the sandpaper. Now we will take 2 test tubes and mark them A and B. In each test tube, we will take 10 ml copper sulfate solution. Now tie them 2 iron nails with the thread and immerse them carefully in the copper sulfate solution in test tube B for about 20 minutes and keep 1 iron nail aside for comparison. After 20 minutes, we will take out the iron nails from the copper sulfate solution. Now we will compare the intensity of blue color of copper sulfate solution in the test tube A and in the test tube B. Also, we will compare the color of iron nail dipped in copper sulfate solution with the other one iron nail which we kept aside. Now, as we compare, first see the figure 1.8B. Iron nails and copper sulfate solution compared before and after the experiment. In this picture, you will observe that in test tube A, the solution of color is blue. And in test tube B, the color of the solution is little bit fade. Because in B test tube, we have dipped iron nail and in test tube A, we did not dip iron nail. So, the reaction take place in test tube B and that's why its color is fade. Here also we can compare in this figure iron nails. One of the iron nail which we did not dip into the copper sulfate, that is same color, and another iron nail which we dipped in the copper sulfate solution, that is there is a brownie coating on the iron nail. That is because of the deposition of copper on the iron nail. Here, copper is less reactive than iron. Or we can say iron is more reactive than copper. So, if we dip the iron into the copper sulfate solution, iron is more reactive and copper is less reactive. Iron will displace the copper from its salt and it will make iron sulfate which is light green in color, and copper will be displaced by the iron. So this is displacement reaction. Some other examples of displacement reactions are zinc plus copper sulfate. Then zinc is also more reactive than copper, that's why it will displace the copper from its salt and forms zinc sulfate and copper. Like that, another example is lead and copper chloride. If we react the lead with copper chloride, we will get lead chloride because lead is more reactive than copper. So that is the zinc and lead are more reactive element than copper. That's why they displace copper from its compounds. So I think now it is clear what is displacement reaction. In the displacement reaction, more reactive metal displaces less reactive metal from its compound. Now we will discuss double displacement reaction. Double displacement reaction. In this reaction, we will do an activity. As the name indicate, in this double displacement reaction, double means two. Two different atoms or group of atoms or ions are exchanged in this type of reaction. That's why the name is double displacement reaction. It means two times displacement. So in this, two different atoms or two different groups or group of atoms are exchanged in double displacement reaction. For this, we will do an activity. Take about 3 ml of sodium sulfate in a test tube, and in another test tube we will take about 3 ml of barium chloride. Okay, one test tube we are taking sodium sulfate and another test tube we are taking barium chloride. Then mix the two solutions. Then what we will observe? We will observe that a white substance which is insoluble in water is formed. This insoluble substance formed is known as precipitate. This is named as precipitate. Any reaction that produces a precipitate can be called a precipitation reaction. So here reaction is sodium sulfate Na2SO4 plus barium chloride BaCl2. Here the ions will be exchanged. Sodium ion will be exchanged by barium ion, and barium ion will be exchanged with sodium ion. Also, we can say sulfate is exchanged by chloride and chloride is exchanged by sulfate. So sodium will make the salt with chloride ion and forms 2NaCl, and barium make the salt with sulfate ion and makes barium sulfate. And the white precipitate which we are getting here, that is due to the formation of barium sulfate. This is due to the formation of this barium sulfate. So here in this reaction, white precipitate of barium sulfate is formed by the reaction of sulfate ion SO4-2 and barium ion Ba2 positive. The other product formed is sodium chloride NaCl, which remains in the solution. We all know that NaCl, sodium chloride, is the table salt which we take in the our food, and it is soluble in water. That's why it will be found in the dissolved form into the solution. But barium sulfate is insoluble, and that's why it will make the precipitate. So in the double displacement reaction, there is the formation of precipitate. That's why these reactions are also called precipitation reactions. And such reactions in which there is an exchange of ions between the reactants are called double displacement reaction. This reaction also we can understand by an activity which we have done earlier also. Then recall, we will recall that activity. Activity 1.2 of NCERT, where we have mixed the solution of lead second nitrate and potassium iodide. Now if we mixed lead nitrate, that formula is PbNO3 whole twice plus Ki. Here for balancing it will be 2Ki. Then lead, it will make Pb2 positive ion, and nitrate NO3 minus ion Here it will be K positive ion and iodide is I minus ion. So lead ion will make the salt with iodide ion and forms lead iodide. Here it will be 2 PbI, and formation of potassium nitrate, 2KNO3 potassium nitrite. Okay, so this is also the example of, there is the formation of yellow precipitate of lead iodide, and this is also an example of double displacement reaction. So friends, like the video, share this video with your other friends, and most important, subscribe my YouTube channel and press the bell icon so that you will get the notification as I will upload my next video.